Joining us in the studio is Dr. Jonas Schmidt-Schanasit, the expert on tropical medicine we've just seen in the report. We have about 390 million people being infected with the dengue virus every year. Yeah. That's what the World Health Organization says. Yeah. How dangerous is that virus really?
Yeah. It's really a serious problem, especially in the high pandemic areas in South America and Southeast Asia. So Brazil is really affected. Last year we detected 1.4 million infections only in Brazil, Thailand, Indonesia, but also India. And this is related to the fact that the virus is transmitted by a mosquito, a vector. And this mosquito, it's called the Asian tiger mosquito, is spreading all over the world.
And it doesn't really seem to stop anywhere. I mean, there was an epidemic on Madeira, the Portuguese island, meaning it will also reach Europe. Is that correct?
Yeah, it reached Europe already. We saw cases in Greece, in France, also in Croatia. So it is already circulating in Europe, not only in Europe, also in the US. We have a lot of cases in Texas and Florida.
Okay, circulating with single cases, but will there be an epidemic too, like we have in Singapore or in Thailand?
Complicated question. So far, we only detected some cases, so not a real epidemic. Mm-hmm. This is related to the fact that the main vector is the yellow fever mosquito, so far is not present in Europe. Mm-hmm. So the Asian tiger mosquito is not the best vector, however, it can transmit the virus, but maybe not cause an epidemic.
And is it actually climate change and the rising temperatures that help the mosquitoes to spread?
No. This is not the main factor, is the globalization, the international trade. This is the main factor, and this led to the spread of the Asian tiger mosquito.
That means that the mosquito is actually traveling all over the world.
In the airplane, sure. If you look in the airplane, I can see every time I see three or four mosquitoes. So this is one of the main factors.
Uh-huh. And you can obviously die from a dengue virus. How risky is it to die? Yeah. How high are the mortality rates?
Yeah, sure. There are severe infections that can lead to hemorrhagic fevers, so with severe bleeding. Mm-hmm. And mostly people in the endemic areas are affected. Children, old people. So normally tourists do not have fatal infections. So this is the good news. No need to fear, but there are fatal infections, lethal infections, and it is a problem. So annually around 100,000 fatal infections, so it also oscillates.
My goodness, and there is no vaccination, so in one way or the other we have to stop the mosquito, is that right? Or how would you react now?
Mosquito control is the key, so we have to focus on mosquito control with methods that need to be developed, like biological control with bacteria that infect the mosquitoes. So these are the keys to control dengue, because so far we didn't have a vaccine and no antiviral therapy. So in my opinion, it will take more 5-10 years to have a vaccine.
Mm-hmm. Now you developed this rapid diagnosing kit for the virus. Yeah. Why is that so important?
This is crucial, because if you can diagnose the infection early in humans, you can treat them very well, and the people don't have to die, because early treatment is a big plus. And
thanks a lot for the talk, Dr. Schmidt-Schanasit.